name is Mad Skillz. I'm an artist, songwriter, an educator, and a DJ. But most of all, I'm a music lover. Can you remember exactly what you were doing on November 29th, 1994? Probably not. But can you remember where you were the first time you heard the song that has now become your favorite song of all time? Exactly. Music and moments go hand in hand. And this is a story about how a lot of music and a lot of moments created a family out of complete strangers. This is the story of the 90s girl Brunch. I remember that day vividly. You know, it was spring, it's nice outside, and everybody was just pretty much doing their day to day. We had heard the word coronavirus, but nobody really knew exactly how serious this was about to be. And the two places that you were going to find out your information at that time was your phone and the television. And for some people, the first time they even heard it might have been a Cardi B video.
Guess what, bitch? Coronavirus!
And you know, we could find humor and melody in almost anything. So me being the person that I am, you know, trying to, you know, get in on the know and be hip, I decided to do a coronavirus DJ mix, which is probably, which wasn't a good idea at all now that I look back at it. And the first song that I used was an intro off of a song that Missy Elliott had called Pass That Dutch.
Listen up, everyone. We have been just informed that there's an unknown virus that's attacking all clubs. Symptoms have been said to be heavy breathing, wild dancing, coughing. So when you hear the sound, run for cover.
Listening back to what she was saying, it's super eerie now because that's exactly what we were about to go through, but we just didn't know it yet. So I started working on the mix. Now keep in mind, I'm trying to be clever here. So some of the songs that I used were songs like... My Corona, get it?
Let me clear my throat.
And being that they were saying that hand sanitizer would kill the virus, I used this song.
Put on your hands with my eyes to see.
And last but not least, I had to use this song.
You can't touch this. Why you standing there, man? You can't touch this.
No. Looking back on it, it was probably not a good idea. But like I said, we didn't know what was about to happen. So I go live on Facebook and do the mix. It went over a lot of people's heads. A couple people got it. But, you know, I didn't think much about it. I posted the mix and I went to sleep. And the next morning, everything changed.
California Governor Gavin Newsom just now announcing, literally a minute and 30 seconds ago, that he is shutting down California.
So I woke up the next day and it's a state of emergency. It was, you know, stay only around the members of your household. Only go to the grocery store and the drugstore when it's needed. This whole thing got real serious, real fast. And I don't care who you were or where you were, you was probably somewhere scared. And the thing about the lockdown was really, like, we didn't know how long we were going to be in it. A couple people thought it might have been for a couple weeks. We had no clue what we were about to witness.
So no more outside activities, no more sporting events, no concerts, no more shared office spaces, and our kids couldn't even go to school.
Everything was shut down, and I had a brunch that particular Sunday at my homie spot, my homie OG Chino, and it got shut down. And being that I still have my equipment set up from the coronavirus mix, I decided to go live again. I got online, started DJing, and I just acted like I was at a brunch.
I've been in my kitchen dancing for I don't know how long.
So the whole time I'm DJing and I'm telling people, you know, go to the buffet.
The buffet is open. Y'all make your way to the buffet.
You know, it's unlimited mimosas. Make your way to the dance floor. I'm acting like I'm at a brunch. And it was funny because the people that were in the chat, it's thousands of people, and they all started just joining along and kind of just going with the theme. Like, so it was like everybody was in on it. Like we were all in this imaginary brunch. But, you know, physically and in real life, we were at home in quarantine. But in our minds, we were somewhere else. It was one of the most joyous occasions that I've ever had online.
I just had a dance party with like all of my favorite VA folks. So
we went from a brunch party to a day party.
Hey, we day partying right now.
Hey, it's Miami.
Oh.
I had DJed online plenty of times. But it was something special about this particular time.
Go Mad Skillz live quarantine. Oh.
I mean, I remember looking at my mentions later and it was a dog dancing. I mean, it was crazy.
And I got offline thinking about it and I was like, man, that was fun. For a couple of hours, my mind wasn't thinking about coronavirus or quarantine at all. And I had extended that service to people. And it just felt good. I remember getting back on my computer and I looked at what I played. And I remember looking at the history of the songs that I played, and it was a lot of music from 90s girl groups. You know, it was Total, it was Faith Evans, it was Mary J. Blige, Toni Braxton, Foxy Brown, Lil' Kim. And I was like, wow. Like, in my mind, I was like, well, you know, what do all these women have in common? And I was like, they were really big in the 90s. Right then, it happened. I was like, I know what I'm gonna call it. It's gonna be the 90s girl brunch.
So I wake up the next day and all I could think about is how much fun I had at this virtual brunch that I just did. So I remember posting like a recap video and I was like, man, should we do another one? And they were like, yes, you killed it. Please do another one. Thank you. Like, it was things like, we didn't want it to end. They were like, please, thank you for doing that. Let's do another one because I'm there. Let's make it happen every Sunday. It's needed.
So I made a flyer, posted the flyer on Thursday. And I remember saying, hey, y'all, brunch, 90s girl brunch is going down Saturday at 1:30. Make sure you pull up. I hit that live button at 1:30 Saturday and everybody showed up.
Oh, baby. was missing. The opposite of fiction, that's facts. Oh, it's a given. I don't care about opinions, that's facts.
Your imagination can take you places that travel could never take you.
Say it, because I was nervous.
No, you don't remember all of it. Right.
And then I started to realize to myself, I was like, wow, like people are coming back.
When was my first brunch?
And I saw a girlfriend of mine post that she was on a live with Mad Skillz DJing.
It was a Saturday.
Actually, my lady invited me to it.
My alert went on, and I was like, what he doing?
Okay, so my first 90s girl brunch was by a complete accident.
It was just so many great hits from the 90s that it was just like, it puts me in a different type of zone, mood, and the camaraderie with the ladies in there. We were all very friendly. We all started talking, so it just created this family environment right away.
I'll just try it. And logged on and I had a ball. I just met all these people.
Skillz was live and I was like, what is this? And I clicked on it and I was like, oh, that's my jam. I think it was a Mary song. I'm sure it was a Mary song. And I was like, okay, this is where I need to be forever.
It was immediately all love.
First one I remember, I actually threw out a flavor for the mimosas. And like, it just, everybody was like, all right, that's the flavor for today. I was like, okay, cool. So this is like inclusive. They cool up in here.
You know, you felt like you were really at brunch.
The first time I went in, real talk, I thought he was really streaming from a spot. I need to go. And I'm scouring the internet frantic, like I can't find this. And I'm texting people like, yo, you heard the 90s girl brunch on Twitch? Like, this shit is fire. And it took about another 30, 40 minutes. And then I kind of was like, he's not really. I felt silly, but that's just how real it came off.
I remember going into my first 90s girl brunch and literally feeling like I was in an actual brunch.
So as I'm DJing, I'm also reading the comments in the chat and I'm just seeing how they're interacting with each other. And I had to ask myself, like, what made them come back?
The actual vibe was different than a lot of the DJs that were on.
How you doing? What's going on? And I enjoyed that.
The vibe, the energy
was, it was so familiar, even when it was my first time, it was familiar. Everybody was so welcoming.
And at first I wasn't gonna fuck with it because I was like, yo, that shit a 90s girl brunch. I'm like, fuck.
What kept bringing me back to the brunch is it just felt so authentic to me.
It was a whole different vibe. Like,
he made it in a way where we were talking to each other.
Of course, it was more women than men, but
it just felt so authentic to me. It didn't feel like someone, a DJ just coming on just playing records. It felt like someone had really created an experience for me, like created this universe of music and love and food and fun and everything like that. It felt comfortable for some reason. So I couldn't get enough. I had to keep coming back.
So after that second weekend, it became clear to me that this was something I was going to do every weekend. Like, I had to do this every weekend. I wanted to do this every weekend. So I started to schedule it. And I was very consistent with it. Every weekend, they knew I was going to be live at 1:30. I wanted them to be able to set their clocks by me. I was very prompt and very on point with the consistency of the brunch. So once we came to the realization that this quarantine thing was going to last way longer than 2 weeks, we all started making adjustments. And a lot of DJs started DJing online. It didn't really matter how big you were in the DJ world or how small you were in the DJ world. We were all bedroom DJs at this point. So after a while, Instagram started to stop the feeds. They would disconnect them while you were live if you played the wrong songs for copyright reasons. So I heard about another platform called Twitch that didn't kill your feed. So I remember asking the brunch, I was like, hey man, if I switch platforms, will y'all come? Somebody said, hey, listen, we going wherever you going. So I did my research on Twitch and realized it's a platform for gamers, but it allows you to use green screens to make your backgrounds anything that you want them to be. So I went out and I got two green screens. The music of the 90s girl Brunch took these people back to a certain time in their lives. It was somewhat nostalgic. So what could I show them that would make them feel the exact same way?
I want style, body and shine. A look that's totally on mine. I want something just for me.
Just for me.
Now my conditioning relaxer cream.
Yep, I'm part of the management team now, mama.
Calvin is the new manager at McDonald's.
We're here to introduce the great new taste of Coca-Cola.
Afro Sheen. I use old commercials that all these women grew up watching. And I had to add that one thing that we could all identify with. Yep, Jet magazine covers. Once that was complete, the new and improved 90s girl brunch was ready to go.
An autograph at the mall. Next in line was a fly girl standing tall. Saw my name and said, give me a call, baby. You know.
Every Saturday and Sunday, we were brunching, having a ball. It became an escape from this global pandemic that we were forced to deal with in our real lives. And I don't remember how I stumbled onto the idea of us having our own chef. I just kind of created her through shoutouts.
Miss Shirley said, y'all better come get this food. Y'all take care of Miss Shirley. Miss Shirley want to know who ate all of the waffles.
And then to my surprise one day, I looked up and it was a real Miss Shirley in the chat.
Which one are you?
Valerie.
Shirley.
Oh, yeah, that was fun. I mean, it gave me a whole bunch of stuff to do, gave me something to do. Being able to connect with and see so many people on there, just having a good time at home. The unlimited mimosas, you know, I'm a mimosa wine girl. But those shows and it just keeps us uplifted and determined to get through this together through music. Music is going to get us through this.
So on Mother's Day, I remember putting my playlist together because, you know, a lot of my female listeners, they have children. Mother's Day is a very hard day for me because I watch people celebrate their moms and my mom is no longer here. So for me, it's kind of a hard day to get through. And but I still wanted to get on and I still wanted to do the brunch. You know, songs like I Will Always Love My Mama and Mama by Boyz II Men. And one of my mother's favorite songs was And Mama Used to Say by Junior. I remember I played that song and I kind of got emotional while I was listening to it because I remember hearing my mom play that song back in the day. I remember how much she loved that song.
Yeah. Yeah. Happy Mother's Day. To all the mothers out there.
And mama used to say, take your time, young man.
My mama used to love this song.
Used to say, don't you rush to get on. Mama used to say, take
it. And it was that second verse when he says, and his mommy passed away, and these words she would say. Man, listen.
Say, and at the time you couldn't understand. I remember looking down could, I didn't want to look in the camera because I was about to cry. When it got to his verse, I'm bawling, crying, in tears. Reading those comments, man, like, reading those comments and them doing what they did for me in that moment, it was bigger than somebody just DJing online. I felt seen, and I remember the last song I played was Optimistic by Sounds of Blackness.
My bad, y'all.
Sir Skillz, I am reaching out to say that I was on your live today. I just wanted to say that I shared in that moment of sadness. My mommy just passed away on Tuesday of the coronavirus. I am trying to accept what will forever feel unacceptable to me. Side note, I remember seeing a post on your page in the past about losing your mother, so I am sure this process of dealing with extreme grief is something you understand. Today, as you play Optimistic and Mama Used to Say, I was crying too. My mom loved music. I believe I get my love for it from her. Thank you for sharing yourself at that moment and making this 49-year-old woman, who will forever be a mama's girl, feel less alone in her grief. Be well, and I'll be watching again soon.
That was the moment when, for me, it became bigger than just a DJing online. It grew into something else.
Trying to get through it. Come on.
Hey, Skillz. It's me, Lily. Somebody told me it was your birthday. Happy birthday to my favorite DJ.
We appreciate you and we love you. Without you, there'll be no Brunch Club family.
Just want to take time real quick to wish you a happy birthday. Say how much we appreciate everything that you're doing for us every weekend from 10:30 to 12:30. It's truly God's work, man.
We appreciate everything you've done to get us through COVID, and happy birthday.
Just want to say thank you for keeping my head nodding since way back when and making me wop it out every weekend on the 90s Girls Brunch. We love you. We love your petty self. Thank you so much for getting us through this pandemic. Much love to you, Skillz.
From your girl, Miss Dot Misha, happy birthday, Mad Skillz.
What's poppin'? Wanted to say thank you for sharing your gift with us. And happy birthday to you, Skillz. Many blessings for your next trip around the sun.
And that's when I knew that this was a special group of people. They weren't like anybody else I had ever encountered in my life. And it was just so dope that they took the time out to do that. And I started to think of ways that I could make them feel as special as they made me feel. So I had this idea where I went to their Instagrams. I started following everybody. I went to their Instagram and I took screenshots of all of their pictures. And I saved them. So it's like hundreds of people. And I took all of their pictures and I made a slideshow of all of their photos.
So at the next brunch, I'm just DJing like I normally do. And then they just saw their pictures pop up.
You know that I love you. And that ain't gonna change.
All of a sudden, out of nowhere, it's like, wait.
I was just in awe. Like, I was so shocked.
I just remember just having a good time in the brunch, and then all of a sudden.
I know those faces.
Who are these people?
Oh shit, that's me.
So I was just like, oh my gosh, this is so cool. My picture better be up there.
I love y'all.
The whole mood in the chat changed.
It was was just one of the most special things I had ever received from someone that I was like literally just coming to vibe and listen to music to, but I'm like, wow, I'm included in this experience, which for me, it just raised the bar like way high from any other sort of DJ experience I've ever had.
It's been such a long time since I've been.
It's really, really made my day. I'm so excited. I screen recorded, I reposted it on my page. It was just a moment. I was so excited. It really was.
It was so dope. I even got emotional. It's the fact that he's a hip hop legend, and the way he shows his appreciation to us, it's really, really dope. It's a good feeling, and it's just amazing, and it's a blessing to watch him work and do what he loves, and then also to be appreciated in those moments. It was hella dope, and that's why I kept coming back.
After that, I started seeing the hashtag We Family. Like, they would put hashtag We Family on everything that was brunch related.
So if y'all don't know, all the girls that be at his 90s girls brunch, he posted all their pictures in a video yesterday, and I was one of them. I was so excited because I definitely was in my feelings, because I was like, all these girls, where my picture at? And then mine came up. So thank you, Skillz. That was so dope and thoughtful, man. That was definitely a great idea. A way to boost our confidence.
I love y'all, man.
So I'm doing the brunches religiously on the weekends, every Saturday and Sunday at 1:30. And then during the week, I would kind of get bored. I was at home, I had read enough books, I watched enough TV shows. I wanted to get back in front of people. So I came up with this thing called Brunch After Dark, where I would play slow songs, kind of like The Quiet Storm, all slow music, ballads, I Love You, you know, sexually suggestive songs. So, Brunch After Dark and 90s Girl Brunch, two totally separate entities. Same people, but they acted different at Brunch in the Dark.
One is PG, no, the one's not PG.
All the boundaries come out.
The first word that popped into my head was nudity. It's funny.
Can I say that on camera?
90s Girl Brunch, daytime, angels. Everyone's like polished and, you know, formal. And then After Dark is like, look, is you ain't, what you doing, what I'ma do, what we gonna do. Holla. Dot, 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 dot.
I say, this nigga dresses for the fucking part? This nigga throws on a fucking button up with the fucking hat?
Don't talk, just listen.
The thing about Brunch After Dark is I would have a red cup and they never knew what was in it. But everybody that knows me knows I can't drink. So, I mean, there's that.
I'm online and, you know, I realize there's a lot of women out there. Some are single, some have husbands, some have boyfriends. And I'm playing these slow songs late at night. And it's the same people in the comments, but they talking different.
No, you were like my brother during the 90s girl brunch, and now I'm checking for you in Brunch After Dark.
Yo, women, y'all are totally different. That family shit goes out the window. And I'm pretty sure if we wasn't so spread it out countrywide, like, because, you know, everybody's in different areas, I'm pretty sure y'all willing to change that We Are Family hashtag shit.
It's a whole different thing. And he got red cups. We never know what's in it, but we know once that red cup comes out, it's a wrap.
It like, happens so quick. And I don't know. It's just funny because we all do it.
That red cup.
They saying some things that I'm like, oh, wow, you just gonna say that on social media? I remember somebody saying he shifts ovaries with records. That might be the greatest DJ compliment I ever heard in my life. He shifts, oh, what? When I read that shit, I was like, oh, I'm that dude. That's a hell of a compliment. He shifts ovaries with records? So then I started saying it in the brunch.
Ovary shift, 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 shift.
Skills.
I know what the fuck I'm doing. I got this. This shit right here. I know what the fuck I'm doing. Let me do what I do.
You're my baby.
But yeah, brunch after dark can be real uncomfortable, especially if you're single.
So usually when I'm DJing, it was this thing that I would say when it was a break of music and it was no words in some of the songs. I would tell the girls in the chat, like, twirl.
Hey, twirl. Now twirl. Come on, twirl. Twirl. Yeah, twirl.
They would put up the little dancing emoji of the lady in the red dress. And that meant, you know, they were twirling somewhere at home. And I can't remember who it was, but... they were like, Skillz, you should make that into a song. So I get my homeboy, Andrew Hypes, I go to his studio and I say, hey man, I wanna make a song called Twirl. And I wanted to feature the Brunch Club. I didn't tell them anything about it. We worked on the song for about two, three weeks. And we finally get a version of the song that that's pretty good. I remember coming back to a brunch and I played it. And just blindly, just played the song. And they listened to it, you can see them in the comments, and they're like, oh shit, he really made this into a song. I told them, I was like, listen, Twirl will be out tomorrow on iTunes, Spotify, you know, wherever y'all listen to music at, you know, Twirl will be on all streaming platforms tomorrow. Now, what I didn't do is I didn't tell them that the song featured them.
Oh yeah, we got our own song, Twirl.
I remember hearing this song and he would just randomly say Twirl.
I'm not kidding, I played it for so many people, like all my friends, whatever, they think I'm crazy.
And then next thing you know, there's a whole song that's developed out of the brunch. I'm like, what is this place? I'm like, this is way more than DJing at this point.
Everybody was saying twirl, twirl. And I was like, oh, this song. For me, I was like, damn, how you come up with a song that damn quick?
Hey, hey, best friend, I need you on the floor. Go best friend, my friend is better than yours. Come now on, twirl. Twirl. I like where you at right now. Swirl. Uh-huh. Yeah. Go queen. Go queen. Go queen.
Swirl. Yeah, like it was crazy because it's like we actually have our own song now. You know what I mean? So y'all know what it is. Like twirl. So it was one particular brunch where I'm DJing, and you know, of course, I look at the comments when I'm DJing, and I read, oh man, Skillz, you killing the reception. And I'm like, how we go from a brunch to a reception? So I'm reading the comments and they say, you know, Bully and D-Bar got married. Bully is probably one of the most outlandish members of the Brunch Club. We don't have a lot of guys, but Bully was probably the most vocal guy. D-Bar was fairly quiet member of the Brunch Club. She would say her piece, but you know, the underlying thing was that, you know, D-Bar low key, I guess to some people, kind of had a crush on me at the time.
I'm gonna say Skillz most pettiest shit ever
Listen, there was a whole wedding.
I was married for a day.
There was actually a wedding.
Came out of nowhere, because then, you know, D-Bar went to the restroom, and then she comes out, she's like, you know, I'm getting married. We're like, what? Who are you marrying?
The wedding between Bully and D-Boy was hilarious.
I really could not tell you how Bully and I ended up married. I want to say in the chat.
Wait, what? It's almost like we're sexing. Who got married?
The wedding. I don't remember the wedding.
They was like, oh, you ain't know. You the wedding DJ.
Wow.
And he just saw people saying, oh, Bully and D-Bar, they married. And took off.
D-Bar, really? I'm your wedding DJ now? Wow. Before you know, I
can't help it. Like, how did we get here? Like, we started this. And now we're at a wedding.
I mean, I thought me and you had a connection. Well, so you just gonna get mad? Wow.
Still got a little petty. You know, Petty Wop had to show up.
Ladies and gentlemen, clearly I have been told that I'm a wedding DJ now. D-Bar has gotten married to Bully. I had no clue. But yeah, so, okay, being that I'm your wedding DJ, D-Bar, this is the song that I want to play for you and your new husband. Yeah, this one goes out to you, D-Bar, and your new husband. From me. Thanks.
Other than I'm at my phone like, really, nigga? You gonna keep this shit going? Like this?
So it was the shenanigans for me. I was on the floor laughing because he played Congratulations.
Wow, I hope you happy.
Cause as long as I can breathe, you'll always be the one. We got married on Saturday, we were doing Boys on Sunday.
What the fuck?
So the next morning, I wake up to all of these Instagram comments about how petty I am. So when I went to the studio later on that evening, I decided to go live.
I'm waiting for the right name to pop up before I ask it, though. I'm in here with Ba. Y'all know Ba. Melissa 57, what's up? We in the studio. So I'm petty. Me. D-Bar, I'm petty.
Yeah.
Bar, am I petty, Bar?
Not a day, bro.
Not a day goes by. Not a day. That I am or I'm not?
That you're not.
Wait. You agreeing. I'm petty.
Nah, you petty as fuck.
Then I see one of my longtime friends in my comments, so I go live with him. Like, surely he could, like, vouch for me.
What, you working on the house?
Nah, man, I'm leaving the radio station, man.
Oh, shit, okay.
But, yeah, hold on. Let me see.
Am I petty, Ivan?
That's why we're friends. What are you talking about? Absolutely. I mean.
So all week long, this is bothering me. Like, I can't get it out of my mind. Like, it's really bothering me. So by the time I get to the brunch Saturday, I asked them to do a poll. And what's that saying? Family will do you worse than a stranger in the street? Psh, bruh. All right,
somebody do a poll. Is Skillz petty or no? Yes or no? Do the poll.
Whatever, man. What'd they say? It'd be the ones closest to you. I mean, but we was like family at this point. And just like any other family, we had our disagreements.
All
All right, so let me explain the whole chocolate cake thing, right?
Oh yeah, Skillz was talking about chocolate cake last night.
I think it was like a Wednesday.
God damn, I don't know what the fuck is wrong with these niggas.
I remember posting a picture of a piece of cake, chocolate frosting, yellow cake, which where I'm from, we call that chocolate cake.
So what happened was he put up a post one time about yellow cake with chocolate icing.
So I started asking people, right? I started asking my friends, and I went to the studio. I never forget. I went to the studio. I walked into the studio, and I asked my friends at the studio.
If I have a yellow cake, a yellow battered cake with chocolate icing, what is that called?
The chocolate cake that I ate was yellow cake with chocolate icing.
It turned into this whole debacle.
If a nigga got a cake that's yellow batter, and chocolate icing on it, what do you call it in Florida?
Chocolate cake.
I'm from Virginia. We call that a chocolate cake.
It's like everybody's going back and forth.
All right, answer this question for me.
Okay, question, right?
It's yellow cake with chocolate icing on it, right? What type of cake is that?
Skillz was upset that people thought it was yellow cake with chocolate frosting.
So what do you call cake that's chocolate frosted and actual chocolate batter? They was like, oh, we call that double chocolate. I'm like, you know, we call that devil's food cake.
If my mom said that's what it is.
My DMs, my mentions were on fire all day Wednesday, all day. I think Thursday night it made it to Facebook.
I can't believe we've been talking about this.
No. Drop your pen. Drop your pen. I'm on the way. I'm sick of you.
You want my location? Are you pulling
up? I'm sick of you. Drop your pen, nigga.
The audacity for me. It's the audacity for me. Is to say that that's chocolate cake.
Who raised y'all?
What is this called? What kind of cake is this?
Chocolate cake!
It's not. It's a butter cake with chocolate frosting.
So by Saturday when I do the brunch, and this is probably the first time that I can remember being, this is probably the first time I can openly admit to being petty. And I started eating the cake. I'm literally eating the cake while I'm DJing.
And then he goes and gets the cake, comes back, eating it like in y'all face.
Like the comments, if you could see the comments were insane.
You know, it's just like, okay. I was just like, yeah, he's King Petty.
So at this point, the brunch had become a staple in people's lives. Like, I would be online DJing and people would be at home cooking, like, real food.
I'm not playing with Miss Shirley today. Skillz, not playing with her. 90s girl brunch, ready.
I mean, we had our own merch. Like, it was a big deal to some people. I remember seeing one person driving down 95 with their laptop open, literally watching the brunch as they're driving down I-95. We started to come together in ways that I never would imagine. Like, for example, it was one brunch member. She was a fitness instructor, so everybody went and took her class. It was another brunch club member. She got COVID, and everybody sent groceries to her house. We watched movies on Mondays, like once a week together. It became a way for generations to bond. And I remember it was a mother and a daughter, and they used to watch the brunch religiously. And this girl, she's way too young to know this music, but her and her mom watched the brunch together all the time. Like, so to her, it was like a TV show. One time, her mom tagged me because her daughter was DJing, like pretend DJing on her kitchen set, acting like me. Like, it was unreal.
If I would play a certain song and I like the vibe and I like the feeling, and I would say I like where we at right now.
Hey, I like where we at right now.
I like where we at right now. That's my favorite.
Wind That Bitch Up. I think that's one of my favorites.
Wind That Bitch Up.
My favorite is Wind That Bitch Up.
Wind that bitch up.
That's my joint right there. Once you say wind that bitch up, I'm winding it up. I don't even care. I'll be in a bed sometimes, but.
Skillz catchphrases. It's always the grunts for me.
I love the grunt.
I love that.
Grr. Don't edit that. Brunch!
One time for good measure. And I had this other thing where I would turn to the side and I would face, I would try to put my shoulder towards the camera and I would start moving my shoulder. I don't know if it was like a, I never called it anything. I don't know what it was. It was like a half a Harlem shake or a shimmy. I don't know.
And it's usually always at the perfect moment because it's right when the groove is hitting. So yeah.
Shoulders like that's right. This is groove. Hey, boom, you mad? Check this out.
So by this time, COVID was still a thing, but the travel restrictions in the United States had kind of been lifted. So I'm traveling back and forth to Virginia from LA, doing the brunch from both coasts. So everything that I had bought in LA to do the brunch with, I had to buy all of that stuff again just so I could do the brunch from another coast. Man, where did the time go? Like, we had been doing this for a year, so on our year anniversary, I played every song in this exact same order that I played it. And I just kind of talked about all our memories through the year. Like, we kind of just went down memory lane.
Y'all remember our first Zoom call? Remember the first time we got on Zoom together? It's been too long, y'all. We've been doing this for a whole year. I'm playing the songs the same way I played them a year ago.
One of the things that I noticed always in the brunch during a year and a half of partying online, Pete, some people would always say, oh man, I can't wait till we can do this in person. And that thought was always in the back of my head. So after a year and a half, lockdown had lifted, quarantine had lifted, there were still light social gatherings. You weren't able to hold concerts, but you were able to have people could gather outside, small numbers of people could gather inside. So always in the back of my mind, I always wondered what it would be like to really meet in person. So I started planning it.
I remember the day where I told them, hey, we gonna do this in person. All y'all gotta do is show up.
The first in-person 90s girl brunch will be on May 29th in the city of Richmond, Virginia. All you gotta do is show up. I got everything else. All you gotta do is be in Richmond on May 29th. Memorial Day weekend. We're gonna do it on a Saturday. The first in-person 90s girl brunch will be on May 29th in the city of Richmond, Virginia. All you gotta do is fucking show up. Just get here.
The comments of that day was surreal because they were just so elated. Because you're talking about people who have become family, but in reality, they've never met each other.
May 29th, Memorial Day weekend, Saturday. We're going to have a real live brunch.
Thank you.
Skillz. We do this every Saturday and Sunday, but today we doing it in a different way. Make some noise for the first live in person 90s girl brunch.
Literally cried three times while DJing. Because it meant that much to me. It was just beautiful to see all of those people love on each other after so long of not being able to.
It was like a family reunion.
It was so dope.
It's something about walking into a room and hugging your family.
For real. It was a dream come true.
We had gift bags. And you got a name tag. So people could see who you were. I'm seeing people crying. One of the most beautiful things I've ever seen. I'll never forget it. Like, we had finally met in person. And it was just as beautiful in person as it had always been in my head. It was perfect. Everything was perfect.
And it just so happens that my birthday was in 3 days. So what did they do? Of course, they brought me a cake.
Let me tell y'all something. If I cut this motherfucking cake out here, and this shit is dark batter, the party is over.
We love you on behalf of the Brunch Club. We thank you so much.
Yes.
And this.
It better be yellow on this side. No, I'm playing.
And I couldn't have done this by myself. I had help from my homeboy Chaos Jones and Vita Mia. She was very instrumental in helping me plan this thing. The Brunch Club knew how important she was to the planning of this as well. So they gave us both awards at the same time. Like, it was super cool.
So the 90s Girls Brunch family loves you. And what you have done, being consistent,
yes,
being a part of our daily lives, because we are in those chats every day. So you have created a family out of strangers. None of us could have ever imagined that we would be right here today. The person that holds us down. If you look at this award, and you look at that award, it looks like it's a piece of that one. So, because Vita is a piece of the family.
Vita!
I would like for you guys to read out loud what your award says.
I can't stand y'all.
Mine says, with love and appreciation, the 90s Girl Brunch family celebrates Mad Skillz, hashtag
we family.
Thank you for holding us down. Love the 90s Girl Brunch. Listen, man, I can't say how much I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. The best gift in the world is to, like I told y'all, the gift was for me to look up and physically be able to see y'all after a year and a half. It's no words that I can say to explain to y'all how much it means to me that y'all made this trip. Some of y'all came a long way, some of y'all came a short way. I don't give a fuck how far you came. The fact that you're here, I appreciate it, and I love you.
After we met in person, man, it was uphill from there. But it was a couple Brunch Club members that couldn't make it, and they were from the West Coast. So we had another one in L.A.
connect again and dance and laugh and sing and talk.
And it just so happens that during the LA brunch, Vita was celebrating her birthday. So we got a chance to celebrate with her.
And then I played Twirl.
Skills, I can't do it. I can't either. Walk with me one time.
Swirl. Swirl. I like where you at right now. Swirl. Uh-huh, yeah. Swirl. That's it. Yeah, come on, twirl. Go queen, go queen, go queen.
It's just dope, man. I never thought that this would all happen for me, going live on my phone to people having relationships that, you know, they'll have for the rest of their lives.
Thank you, first and foremost, because the family that you've created, we here now, we gonna be there.
I had COVID, and I had COVID really bad. And I put in the chat, and I was really struggling with it. Skillz asked me how I was doing, and I hadn't even had family members or coworkers to ask me how I was doing. And Skillz brought a lot of people out of their shells, especially me. I traveled for the first time by myself to go to the live brunch.
I don't know what I would do right now without 90s Girl Brunch. Like, it's a part of me.
I would like to say to Skillz, thank you for saving my life. In times of uncertainty with the pandemic, in times of anxiety, dealing with mental health issues and depression, he was consistent, if not anything else. And that was a major part, I think, of all of us getting through 2020. And 2021. So I thank him.
Family. 90s Girl Brunch is definitely like a family.
Thank you. You got me through my divorce. You connected me with people who supported me, supported my business. You gave me friends who value me for me.
You know, I became closer, I think, with my daughter just because she was home. We were able to connect over music and cooking and pour mimosas.
As far as what the brunch has meant to me is one word. It's just love.
I would say thank you. You know, we really appreciate it. As much as we like to have fun together, like, it's really saving lives out.
You brought normalcy back to us.
Skillz does, which I'm the third person, is a true ministry. And that's something different that you don't get. I've never seen it anywhere else.
What he's doing is, it's not only just cool, but like, it's so necessary.
The 90s Girl Brunch to me, like, is like, I ain't gonna say it's a lifesaver, but it's definitely been a plus for my mental health.
I didn't know any of these people before, and now I feel like I have friends for life.
You created something that means more to people than you actually realize.
It's 90s Girl Brunch for life. We family.
Are you in a rush, Skillz?
No. I'm not rushing, but it's like, I mean, the brunch started in like 30 minutes. And we fly just like birds of a feather. I won't tell no lie. All of the people around us, they say, can they be that close? Just let me stay for the record. We're giving love.
Being a part of this online community has been amazing for the past year, and to actually just get to meet all of my family in person is just a great, great, great honor. Skillz, you are my DJ bae. I follow you all around, and I'm just over the moon excited to finally get to meet everybody in person for the first time. It's been great.
Hi, this is Mary 2470. I just want to say thank you, Skillz, for having our very first in-person brunch. Words can't describe how I feel right now. It's like surreal. Seeing my family, seeing you guys spinning for us in person is unbelievable. To be there at Art & Noise with you last night and then to be here, I just want to tell you thank you. From the bottom of my heart, you mean so much to me and the Brunch Club. We love you, we love you, we love you, and I can't stop dancing. Oh my God, it's so fun. So thank you again, and I'm out.
Hey, what's up, Skillz? It's Sean Spades. Obviously for the last year or so, with everything going on, COVID, you know, we built a tight-knit community, started on the gram, moved over to Twitch. I mean, it's been amazing, something to look forward to every weekend. Thank you. All I can say is thank you. And to be here for the first one, it's amazing, man. Bless you. Thank you for everything you've done for all of us, especially being here right now.
Hey, it's Five Footer. Just wanted to say thank you so much, Skillz, for changing and saving my life. Being here with the Brunch Crew, the Brunch Club, one of the best things that's ever happened to me. And I met a whole group of other sisters and brothers because of you.
Thank you so much, Skillz. I am elated, elated to be outside and to be in the 90s Girl Brunch live and in person. Thank you for all you have done to get us through the pandemic. But we outside now, baby.
Hey, Skillz, it's me, Lily. This is the most amazing thing to be here with all these people that I met
a year ago because of you and your music. I can't say enough about how excited I am. Thank you for who you are. Thank you for your pettiness. Thank you for your music. And I truly appreciate you more than you will ever know.
Hi, this is Marsha, aka The World Through My Eyes. I am so blessed to be here. Doing it virtually for the past year. It's been a blessing just to have a little breather doing, you know, Saturday and Sunday chores, running my mom around, doing my crafts, doing my hobbies. Skillz, I just want to say thank you so much for having this done in person. We love you. Thank you.
Oh, being here is so surreal. It's like amazing. Being away from them for a year and not knowing who none of these ladies are and some of the guys too. And then being here physically is like really, really surreal. I can only say thank you to Skillz. If it wasn't for him doing this for us, we wouldn't be what we call a family. This is Dance with a Chef on Instagram. We family, 90s Girl Brunch.
At Kells Pearl here, I am telling you it's so surreal to be live and in person with my brunch baddies and Skillz today. It's been a year in the making. We're really family. It's like a reunion with people I've never really seen in person. Thank you for putting this together for us, Skillz. We appreciate you. We family.
Hey, Skillz. This is Classy T, also known as Terry. And I just wanted to thank you for everything you've given us over this last year and some change. It has been such a privilege to be in the brunch club. It has been so much fun watching you be super pretty. I love your stories. Cannot wait until the book comes out. You have brought a smile to my face. I pumped the music loud. We watched the movies on Monday nights. Just thank you so much for being there for all of us. Thank you for keeping Virginia on the map, two up, two down. Virginia, always represent Virginia. So thank you so much for everything, Skillz. We love you, we're family, and I appreciate you so much.
Yo, what's up, Skillz? It's Catino, at Catino VA. Want to thank you for putting this together. It's been crazy listening to you every weekend with my wife. She's in love with your Sunday brunches. Real crazy to be here live in person for the first time. I've been rocking with you since Nas back then, my favorite rapper. It's been real just being here and being experienced this whole event that you put together live, man. It's awesome.
Let me tell you how I feel to be here. Boy, you done outdid yourself. Let me tell you something. You on fire. And you showing off.
Skillz, we did it. Finally here. And it was on my birthday weekend. Such an amazing, amazing weekend. From the bottom of my heart, I just want to say thank you for what you do. Thank you for being consistent. Thank you for loving on us and letting us love on you. Let's keep doing this. Let's keep doing this. Hashtag we family. Love you, Skillz.
I would have to say that this right here has to be the most amazing moment of 2021.
What's up, Skillz? It's Honey V Fly. I'm so happy that we are finally in person. We did it, Joe! 90s Girl Brunch Live. It's a year and a half in the making. I am so excited to see everybody. I'm so excited I dressed for the occasion. I got some 90s Girl earrings made and everything. Skillz, you are the best for doing this. We love you so much. We're going to continue to rock with you and the best for everything. 90s Girl Brunch, we did it!
Hey, yo. This is Aunt Mama Sissy Cat right here at the 90s Girls Brunch. I want to say this has been an extraordinary experience coming in. Meeting everybody has been amazing. I just want to say, Skillz, thank you so much for bringing us all together, and hashtag we are family.
Hey, Skillz, it's Philly girl Reese. I'm so excited to be here today. This is a long time coming, a year in the making, and the energy is just off the chain. It's crazy. And we all so happy to finally meet up and just connect and hug and dance. And it's all because of you.
Hey, Skillz, this is Champ Lifestyle. And my real name is Chandra. I just want to say that this is so amazing what you have built. I love this online community so much. I know you've heard it time and time again, but we cannot express enough how much of an impact you've made on our lives during this time at COVID. and to actually start an online community and transfer it into a real life community is one of the most amazing things I've been a part of. I thank you so much for that.
Yo, what's up? It's Jess Jenny B. Man, this is life. 90s Girl Brunch in real life means everything. It's family, it's friends. We connected for life. This is a whole movement. Yo, Skillz, to the best, headiest DJ in the whole wide world, we love you. I love the whole 90s Girl Brunch family. Yo, for real, we connected for life. I love y'all.
Skillz, I just want to say thank you for everything, for bringing us all together, because we family.
Skillz, we did it, Skillz.
All right, first off, shout out to my brother, big brother. Skillz, you pulled it off. We've been locked up for years of change, and we finally met. And I just want to say this to all my sisters. Y'all not my sisters.
Yo, Skillz, it's your girl. La La means love. 90s Girl Brunch and the Hizzles. It's been so freaking amazing. We came back outside in royal fashion. 90 Girl fashion. We love you, Skillz.
Amy Giddish, thank you so much for this. This is so amazing. One of the best days ever. For real, thank you so much.
Hi, this is Miss Marissa 71, also known as Marissa. Just want to say this was absolutely so much fun. After all we've been through for the last year and a half with this COVID, and to finally get out and meet people that are totally strangers, and we are one big family. So Skillz, I love you. Thank you for doing this, and you will always be my friend and family. Thank you.
Skillz, I had to come back because I forgot. I know you don't do requests.
I am so, so, so excited to be here. This is my first time here. I was invited by my best friend, Danny Boo. This is so great that you have something like this for us during this time. So just keep up the good work. 804 Northside till the day I die.
90s Girl Brunch Crew, the Brunch Baddies, we are here live and in person. Yes, it's been a year in the making, a year coming, but we are here. We are family. We've been vibing together online for a whole damn year. And it's so good to meet each and every one of you, even though I don't know none of y'all government names. Them handles came in handy today. Skillz, my boy, my family, my brother, thank you so much for bringing this to us, for getting us through a pandemic, getting us through hard times, because you know music is life. It's a love language. And we thank you for bringing the love language to us. Thank you for this behind us. We celebrate you, my brother. Thank you so much for everything.
Hey, listen, when I tell y'all, I can't explain what it feels like to be here the first live 90s Girl Brunch. I got Shot Boogie. I got Shot from the Boogie. I got my man Fish. This has been a year and a half in the making. And to everybody that came, I'm so appreciative of y'all. I love y'all so much. We did it. Like, we really came out in person when the world opened back up. And I just gotta say, I love y'all, man. Like, y'all the best. We family. You already know what it is, man. 90s Girl Brunch for life, all right?
Hey, yo, Skillz, I just want to say, damn, so many sugar mamas out here, man. I'm only 29 years old. I done got, like, 5 Instagrams, you know what I'm saying? Thank you, bro. Like, hopefully one of these sugar mamas pay for my child support, man. And shout out to my mom, Ebony. She the one that got me out here, man, because this joint fire. This joint lit.